think about resilience. And she asked me earlier, I was paid to be the first one to answer questions. I think it's all good. But I was thinking about the power. I was thinking about resilience. When I first started Jones, a few people know I lost my husband. And I had the idea for Jones for about a year. I kept thinking about it and crafting it and writing books about it. And I thought it would be this cool idea. And it was just one of those things that circulated with me for a long time. And I talked about it with my husband and thought, wouldn't this be cool? Wouldn't this be neat? And so I was like, why don't you do it? What's holding you up? And I was like, well, you know, these kids and they gotta eat. You know, I can't leave them the job and all of that. And then when I suddenly lost him, I was, again, to your knees. Just completely bereft, and I really rolled her upside down, didn't know what was going to come next, just devastated, probably my lowest point, and couldn't, wasn't even emotionally stable enough to go back to that good job, and be in a state of mind where I could be productive, and I could move on with things, and I could, you know, type a letter, or, you know, do whatever I needed to do, and as time passed, I kept thinking about Jones. And I remember him saying, why don't you do it? You ought to do it. You should really do this. What's the hold up? And I had my notebook full of notes and all the things that I wanted it to look like and tear sheets all over the house. I really made a mess of things. And that's when I started it. And it was sort of like a resilience. It was kind of like, I can get through this. Let this take me through this. And through much prayer and much fasting, I'm sure, much prayer for my family. It was one of those obstacles that I didn't see, you know, at the time when you lost someone. There's just really nothing else for you. You just feel like that's the end of it. There's nothing good is going to come out of this. Nothing could possibly spring up from it. And I look back, and that was like 6 years ago. And I'm like, what? This is crazy. Gary Vee looked completely floored to be here now. And to see this, and to see us in here in Miami, talking about resilience, power, you know, empowering things. And I think back, I'm like, I can't believe that I almost kind of didn't do this. I almost didn't. I almost let that sort of despair, and that's the word, despair, flood me over and stop everything. And so I always think about power in terms of resilience and obstacles as something like, I can get through this. When I didn't feel like I could get through it, and I didn't see any other way, you know, here comes this idea again, and it could have only been God. That said, you know, push forward, make this happen. And I look back, and I was like, God, I lost my job behind this. This, you know, I wasn't really able to get back to this job. I had all my faith, these were all my ducks in a row. I had a 401k there, my safety net. And to leave it felt like, are you crazy? You know, what could possibly happen? And then I look back on it, and I'm like, wow, I can't believe how much has changed. I can't believe that there really is something else. There is life that comes through that. There are other things for you when you don't feel like there's anything else for you. So I always think about obstacles as like one more thing that I gotta get past. Just one more thing. It doesn't have to be this big. And I no longer have this sense of entitlement. For a long time I did think it was about me. You know, you do, even in your 40s, you think it's about you. And I have learned some great lessons from this, of resilience and getting through things and not letting everything stop right there. Not letting your entire world stop behind even the hugest thing that you can do. To me, the biggest thing for me is loss. It's still a big challenge. Just losing somebody is just the biggest challenge. But I think about, wow, look how far we've come.